Okay, so in this video, I'm going to be talking about Carnap's Logicist foundations of mathematics. I can't remember if this was an article by itself, if it was published in a journal, or if it was in a book that he wrote. I forget. But it is in an anthology which is called The Philosophy of Mathematics, and it is edited by Paul Benacer, I believe. But in this anthology, you have Carnap hating, and maybe it's Dubnik, I'm not sure, but there's a few thinkers, including Carnap and hating, who talk about the foundations of mathematics, and logicism being Carnap, intuitionism being Hayding, and formalism, I forget who did the formalism one, and I'll be talking about each one in a different video. And this one, I want to talk about his writing on the logicist foundation of mathematics. So, first off, logicism is a philosophy of mathematics. It states that mathematics has foundation in has that that number in mathematics has its foundation in logic, and in most versions, in versions of Frege, at least it is a realism. It is a mathematical realism about numbers, that numbers are objectively real, and in some writings they're abstract entities, almost like a Platonic sort of mathematical philosophy. But logicism states that mathematical entities and number is all reducible to logical entities and logical processes. So Carnap is saying that the logical and epistemological foundations of mathematics are not solved yet. And he's questioning this: how do mathematics and logic relate? And the question is, what is the foundation of number? What is the foundation of mathematics itself? Some might say that it's a realism, like a logicistic realism, or a set theoretic realism. Set theory does play big in logicism too, but with logicism you have a few different people. You have Frege and his Grundlagen. You have Russell and his writings, and also Russell's large piece of work with Alfred North Whitehead, which is called Principium Mathematica, which is their thing, which is their huge three-volume work, which basically shows how you can reduce mathematics into logic using set theory. And it's all axioms and logical formulas and stuff like that. It's not really that much, not really that much writing in there. It's mostly just all formulas and, well, not really formulas, but axioms and logical sentences and stuff like that. So there are a few things that you can think about when you talk about logicism. First is that the concepts of mathematics can be derived from logical concepts through explicit definitions. Secondly, theorems of mathematics can be derived from logical axioms purely through logical deduction. And Carnap talks about the derivation of mathematical concepts. The derivation is the propositional calculus. Mathematical concepts derived from logical through logical concepts. That's the main rules when we do logic. Negation, disjunction, conjunction, unconditional, or implication, and the biconditional. And there's lots of use of functions here where we have the function f of a, which is the property f belongs to, or the property f belongs to, belongs to the individual a. And when we do predicate logic, we're using the universal and the existential quantifiers, we have the functional calculus, where we're talking about universality, we're talking about existence when we use the upside down A and the backwards E. And some of these things are reducible to others. And the problem of logicism is to derive natural numbers from logical concepts. And that's what Frege did, and that's what Russell and Whitehead did together. Russell has his logical theory of types, or his ramified theory of types. I do have a video which I think is pretty good about Russell's theory of types. And if the theory Russell's theory of types talks is basically is using types to derive natural numbers from logical concepts, and I'll talk about that in a minute. Frege had a theory of types, and then Russell kind of muddied the waters using his ramified theory of types, where let's say we have the number 3. 3 objects always fall under the concept of 3. So we can take the natural number 3 and sort of show how we can, through logical deduction or through explicit definition, we can show how that is itself a logical concept. 3 objects falling under a certain concept. Functions and gaps or cuts. So that's Dedekind and Russell talked about how functions have to do with gaps or cuts between things. And we have the idea of constructivism, which Carnap does mention, and how we can use sets to talk about numbers. How real numbers are not postulated, but they are constructed, that they really abstractly, objectively exist, but we have to construct them out of sets. And logical constructions, we use logical constructions and explicit definitions to basically do all this. Now we have the derivation of theorems, which is Russell's theory of types, where we have type 0, which is individuals like A or B. Type 1 is properties of individuals, like the function f of A or the function f of B. Type 2, properties of individuals, where we have the function f of a, or g of f of a. Type 3, we have the property of a property of a property of individuals, where we have, like, you know, the functions just get bigger. But hopefully you can see how these logical concepts and these logical constructions out of sets and stuff like that and functions can be used to talk about numbers. And where the idea is meaningful, is a meaningful predicate which can be applied to lower types. Russell's ramified theory of types, where he has orders and he has levels, he has the axiom of reducibility, where higher orders can be reducible to lower orders. And basically, he has this whole theory of types, which, you know, one could basically go over and talk about for a very long time. It's very extensive in Russell's work alone, as well as his work with Whitehead. And my explaining it here or my explaining it in the other video are not going to really do it a whole lot of justice. If you want to find that video, you can go into my philosophy of mathematics and logic playlist, and it'll be in there. I think I did it last year, maybe this year. I'm not quite sure about that. But basically, with Russell and Whitehead, and even with David Hilbert's formalism or his deductivism, with all of these people, you have them having this whole logical mathematical system with which they try to verify the system as to its consistency by using the system itself, and that's where you have a problem. Gödel pointed that problem out. And basically with Frege and Russell in their correspondence with Frege's system, Russell pointed that problem out with his paradox. With the issue of impredictivity, we have the issue of Russell's paradox, where an impredicatively defined concept is meaningless, where something has to be predicative, has to be predicating at something to have any sort of meaning. Where we have the paradox of the barber, Russell's paradox, which is the paradox that we have a town of people who don't shave themselves. However, there is a barber in that town who shaves everybody, but nobody in that town shaves themselves. So who shaves the barber? That's the whole paradox right there. You have the town, which almost in a way represents a system of mathematics or logic, where you have the statement where nobody shaves themselves, but you have a barber who shaves everybody. That's a difficult thing, and it's kind of hard to see it, but you kind of have a lot of issues with that. Gödel kind of pointed out more explicitly, but you have this problem of impredictivity in itself. How you have to have something has to predicate at something for a concept to have meaning, and you have this person who comes along named Ramsey, solves it by stating that numbers exist before we construct them. And that's kind of where later along you have this quantum Putnam indispensability, which has basically came along later in the philosophy of mathematics, which is basically that you have to argue and abide in Platonic realism pertaining to number for mathematics to be useful to science, for mathematics to have any real meaning or any real use to science, because you can't have a system of mathematics or logic in itself by itself, and that is how things exist because we construct them. And that's the only thing, and try to define the consistency or try to figure anything out about the system from within the system, you kind of have this issue. But that's kind of a more farther down the line problem with Gödel. But the main problem of impredictivity is that something has to predicate for anything to have real meaning, and Ramsey's saying that mathematics is it exists before we construct it kind of solves the issue a little bit. And then when we get to, you know, Gödel, or well, when we have Hilbert and his program, and how Gödel kind of just crashes the whole thing down, we have even more of a issue here. But Carnap is in a way kind of going back and talking about logicism as it was then. And I believe, yeah, I believe that was before Gödel. But I guess I want to read more about Gödel and sort of talk about that more, because I think, I mean, I was taught philosophy of mathematics in a class a while back, so that's where I, you know, was first taught all this, and I've read a lot since then, but I kind of want to read into Gödel a little bit more, and then make some videos on that. But this is kind of a look by Carnap into logicism with himself and Russell Whitehead and also Frege. And since then, we've had neologicists like Crispin Wright and Demopoulos, I think is what it is, that one. And they have an idea of a neologicism, which kind of is sort of revitalizing, you know, the trend of Frege and Russell. But